everyone. Welcome to the WNBA on 2K Sports. Tonight, it'll be the Chicago Sky going up against the New York Liberty. Along with Tim Swartz and Brian Benefitemi, I'm Blake Suniga, and we're happy to have you along for another great game. And Brian, when we talk about a player being crafty or doing the little things that make a difference, what are some examples of that?
Well, above all else, Blake, I think it's doing stuff that ticks off your opponent within the rules. You know, just little bumps, little nudges. You're aiming to throw them off their game.
I think it's just getting those 50-50 balls, getting extra possessions, offensive rebounds. That can be the difference between a win and a loss in a tight game, in a playoff game.
And yep, it's good.
Only one player in the history of the WNBA has made more two-point buckets than Tina Charles. Making hoops inside is her bread and butter.
Now here's Dolson. Vandersloot with it, and Nurse picks her up defensively. Six to shoot. Pass to Lavender. Shoots over Boyd. And it's Lavender missing.
Well, that's just not a sight you see very often because she has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when she's open.
I like the move she made to come free, give herself a clear lane to the hoop.
Vandersloot outside to the paint. And the basket by Lavender.
You can see why she has the best career assist average in WNBA history. Vandersloot, she really just sets up open shots, leads the easy points.
Now here's Charles. Outside Boyd. Zowie B, guarded by Dolson. Zowie B's shot is off.
If she can get to the rim, she'll usually turn it into points, but the defense stood tall there.
Pass to Dolson. Here's DeShields, covered by Zowie B. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Showing some physicality on that play. DeShields is terrific at finishing through contact.
Outside Durr.
Right here, right here.
Charles. Now here's Boyd. Lays it up and banks it in.
That's exactly what they're going for in that possession.
First quarter ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Here's Quigley.
Well, while some players blossom right away, others like Allie Quigley take a little bit of time. Didn't play much early on, but knew her moment would come someday.
Yeah, it's her first trip to the line. Off.
Well, she went from someone who didn't even play 10 minutes a game to a player making all-star games. Allie Quigley, a great example of work and perseverance.
Good on the second free throw. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Pass to Zowie B. Now Charles. And she takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. And despite being patient early on in her career, Allie stays in attack mode all the time now.
Yeah, she plays aggressive and looks for her shots. And with the chip on her shoulder, it's pretty hard to intimidate her. And she's just a player that her teammates want her to pull the trigger.
And we're about 3 minutes into this first quarter. Count that bucket.
And the offense, 3 of 4. A solid start to the game, if I say so myself.
Left side, Boyd. Outside Durr. Clock at six. Just under 3.5 minutes elapsed here in the first quarter. Misses from close range. The drive by Diamond to Shields. Her second shot goes in. Off to a good start. 2 for 2.
4 or 5 shots have dropped for them already. Not a bad way to get things started.
Pass to Nurse. Boyd. Now Zawi B. Vandersloot defending. Nurse outside. And here's Charles. She's guarded by Lavender. And they'll turn it over. Couldn't get a shot off. That's a 24-second violation. On the wing, Diamond to Shields. Pass to Vandersloot. Quigley with it. Boyd covering. From past the arc, here's Lavender. Yes, and it's Allie Quigley picking up the assist.
Her shooting percentage is through the roof right now. What a great start to this game.
Outside Boyd. Here's Nurse. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot two. Stephanie Dolson picks one up.
A top 10 pick out of Connecticut. Kia Nurse comes from a family of athletes. Her father played pro football. Her mother, hockey. She's a great competitor growing up with sports in her family.
Two shots.
And she makes the first. Well, guys, there's so much talent in this league beyond the superstars. Of that category, who are some of your favorite players to watch?
Well, Blake, I like the game of Elizabeth Williams. She's won the Most Improved Player Award not too long ago, a capable scorer and rebounder. She's also a quality shot blocker, always lurking around to make plays.
Well, I gotta say, I'm a huge fan of Jonquel Jones, a rising star in this league. She's already one of the WNBA's best rebounders. She also has a solid handle and can hit from long range. Talk about a unique combination of skills.
Now here's DeShields. Over Durr. And that one goes long.
She kind of short-armed that shot after doing a nice job of getting open.
Brittany Boyd draws the double. Zawi B. Nurse, guarded by Quigley. Outside, just 5 to shoot. Right block shot, and the nice bucket inside from Zawi B.
One of the advantages for Nurse, she's 6 feet, so tall for a point, allows her to get a clear view of the whole court.
Now here's Vandersloot. Outside Quigley. Pass to Dolson. Quigley. From downtown, drains the three-pointer.
In the WNBA, you need to score points when it isn't easy. Quigley, mentally strong, just focusing on the hoop, not the D.
Zawi B with it, guarded by Dolson. Here's Charles. And they double up Tina Charles. Pass to Durr. Back to Charles. Down it goes for her third basket in as many tries.
Tough make. You don't end up making over 2,000 baskets like Charles without some hard ones.
And good that time. New York trailing here. Outside Boyd. Now here's Nurse. Charles. He's guarded by Lavender.
That's the way you want to defend. Nice job there.
Always so important to have that strong interior defense.
Vandersloot outside. Kicks it out to DeShields. Dolson. It's good. The assist that time from Diamond DeShields.
Using A-plus awareness to find the wide-open teammate, DeShields doesn't mind distributing.
Pass to Zawi B. Nurse, guarded by Quigley. Outside Boyd. Brittany Boyd draws the double. An open look for Kia Nurse.
A tremendous shot blocker. Dolson's length at 6'5" and defensive IQ lead the Swats. Both teams on fire right now from the opening tip.
This is going to be an entertaining game of basketball today, folks. I think that much is obvious.
Get your popcorn ready.
Outside Boyd. Zowie B. And it's good. 2 points.
I like the recognition that we're seeing from Boyd. And she kind of makes it effortless the way she locates her open teammates.
Now here's Vandersloot. Quigley, good. Here's Boyd. Nurse outside. Shot clock at 5. Outside Charles. And it's blocked by Stephanie Dolson. Up top, Quigley. Defended by Nurse. Pass to Lavender. To Shields. Whistle blows. Yep, that's going to be a travel. Outside. Pass to Allen. Now here's Hartley, covered by DeShields. It's Kia Nurse on the wing. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Drops it in from 11 feet.
Another lead change. How many of these are we going to see?
I don't know, but I'm willing to bet it's more than a few.
Vandersloot outside. Fires from the wing. And there are the Sky with another bucket. Here's Hartley. Pass to Nurse. Launches it. The rebound by the Sky.
She may have been surprised to find herself so open. I mean, maybe that's why she missed.
Down low. Dolson's shot's good.
8 of the last 10 points. That's right, you heard me right. 8 of their last 10 points at that end of the court have been scored on very high percentage shots in the paint. Something's got to change.
You know, the defense making it far too easy for them, and they're taking advantage.
Now here's Nurse. 6 points for her. She made that one. Basket number 3 for her, and she's also missed 2.
Took advantage of some shoddy D there. They gotta at least get a finger on her.
Vandersloot with it. Hartley picks her up. Here's Copper. Over Nurse. Copper no good.
And for the Sky, they're still looking to get some momentum going with this group. They've had a hard time finding success in that post-Deladon era. And, you know, it's just always hard to lose a star player like that.
Now here's Charles. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Sky.
That is an unforced error if I've ever seen one, guys. Just not an ideal pass.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. Chicago leading. And for the Sky, they got a solid return in the Deladon deal, but it takes time.
And when you're in a market like Chicago, you aren't given a lot of patience during a rebuild. That franchise, it's really a franchise that hasn't had a lot of success over the years. The pressure is mounting in the Windy City for the Sky to put together a team that can just compete for a title.
Now here's Hartley. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Yes, it's good.
Put herself in a great position to finish that break off.
Yeah, and that right there is just a great read of how the play was developing and where the ball was going.
Such high basketball IQ.
Here's Wright. Hartley outside. Offensive rebound. And good work on the boards, and they pick up the second chance points.
Terrific job to convert the putback. She stayed with that play from start to finish, and that's something we say about her a lot.
7 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession. Here's Copper. 6 on the shot clock.
Height, length, leaping ability. Charles has it all to be a great defender. But most importantly, she has desire.
This one for 3. And released it in time, but it's off the mark. And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Sky out in front. They lead by 3. And the second quarter is on the way when we return. And we got a close game here as we get back to the second quarter. And when you consider how the Sky are doing, guys, what are your thoughts?
A lot of blocks. It set the tone defensively for them.
Yeah, just stonewalling them. And the rest of the game, shooters will be hearing footsteps after the blocks they put up this quarter.
Now Faulkner. Outside Williams. That's her second shot and her second basket. My math says that's 2 for 2.
I'll bet her percentage is pretty high from that range.
Now here's Wright. She's guarded by Williams. Johannes. Yes, and it's Tanisha Wright picking up the assist.
Look at the soft touch. Just a gentle little teardrop.
Outside Faulkner. Pass to Parker. It's Gabby Williams on the wing. Pulls up on the elbow. Off the left rim and out. New York trailing here. Starting the second quarter and about a minute gone. Pass to Wright. Johannes. Shot clock at 6.
Yo, look at the clock.
Shot's good by Wright. Chicago with the ball. Outside Faulkner. Outside Parker. To Copper. 6 on the shot clock from deep. Recovered. Parker gets the bucket.
Some defensive breakdowns happening now. Their last 4 buckets allowed have come from very close range.
And giving up these high percentage shot attempts, it's not going to get it done. They need to figure it out.
Here's Johannes. Stolen by Faulkner. Outside Williams. Pass to Endor. So the whistle blows on the shot. 2 free throws for the contact there. It's going to be on Amanda Zowie B.
With the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
That's some old school defense. Just telling them no easy layups. As simple as that. And I like to see it.
Free throw is good. Well, the WNBA recently made changes to not just their postseason format, but their regular season format as well. Do you guys like these changes?
Well, I think it's good for the league, Blake. You know, I like how teams now play 18 games against their opposing conference instead of 12 Now that allows fans to see more of those cross-conference matchups that they may have been craving. Also, it could help some rivalries develop, which to me is always fun.
Yeah, and as far as in-conference, teams used to play 5 games against 2 teams and 4 games against the remaining 3 teams. Now in this new format, teams play 4 games against 1 team and 3 games against the remaining 4 teams. More balance.
5 on the clock. 14 feet out.
Endor with the rebound.
One item that stood out is their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it's tough to defend.
To the middle. Here's Parker.
Not afraid to bump and bruise down low. Parker is fearless around the rim.
And first trip to the free throw line for her in this one. Good on that one.
5th pick in the 2015 WNBA draft. And you know, with all the pressure that comes with being a top pick, I think Parker's handled it well and is progressing nicely in her WNBA career.
And she sinks the second.
They've changed their game here in the second, getting a little more physical.
And look for them to increase this lead if they keep getting to the line.
Pass to Charles. Oh, hammered. Wow. Yeah, she'll go to the line.
So Tina Charles has had lots of great years in the league. But 2012 was arguably her final. Charles averaged double-double, garnering MVP honors for Connecticut.
Shooting 2.
And she knocks down the first one. Yeah, for Charles in 2012, winning MVP in just her 3rd year in the league.
And guys, she carried Connecticut, leading the team in points, rebounds, and blocks. And she helped the Sun finish 25-9, owning the best record in the East.
And that's good as she hits both shots.
The top pick in the 2010 draft, Tina Charles, made an immediate impact, winning Rookie of the Year, averaging a double-double with the Sun.
Now here's Williams. Softly drops in the floater.
They're just killing them in the paint.
You can say that again. I mean, the defenders aren't being nearly aggressive enough down low.
They're just killing them in the paint.
Thank you.
Here's Zowie B. Pass to Johannes. Charles. Here's Johannes. Right outside. Charles. Faulkner defending. Charles with the bucket.
It's not just close in. Charles also flourishes in the mid-range. Unfair to stop.
Now here's Faulkner. Tight defense on her. Outside Williams. Get out. 13 feet out. Johannes with the rebound. Now here's Wright. Faulkner defending. Shoots and misses. 0 for 1 to begin the game. Pass to Copper. Here's Endor. And she banks in the layup.
So poised on the offensive end of the floor. Parker is a dependable scorer.
Here's Johannes. Faulkner defending. Shots good by Johannes.
Intelligent passing to make that basket possible.
Chicago leading. And here's Faulkner. Outside Williams. Pass to Endor. And here's Faulkner. Rebound, Tina Charles. Here's New York now. Wright with it. Here's the teardrop. Charles misses the layup. She had her with that pump fake, but couldn't make her pay. Right side, Faulkner. Up and in. Off to an efficient start. 2 for 3 from the field.
That's a great job, really, to angle her body, shield the bigger player from the ball on her way to the basket.
And you have to know how to finish like that if you're going to take it down low. And she showed all the capabilities of doing so.
Now here's Wright. The shot that time not on target. Jamira Faulkner goes in. Good. And it's Gabby Williams who picks up the assist.
Very clever passing. She put that ball on a silver platter for her.
Timeout called the Liberty.
Yeah, coach wants to get everybody on the same page out there and maybe change up some things as well.
Yeah, that's probably a good timeout. You might as well talk things through.
And kind of change that game plan as well.
Hartley, right side. Courtney Vandersloot with some nice D. On offense, here the Sky. They lead by 8. That's the biggest margin of the game. Outside to Shields. Vandersloot, it's good. The assist that time from Diamond to Shields.
That's a nice bucket. They're really playing intelligently.
They really are, and even though it's not a huge lead they've got, they're definitely in charge.
Kind of get that feeling, Brian, that team is playing so well.
The shot by Nurse, no good.
Well, this is why you need good defenders inside contesting shots.
Yeah, making every shot a tough shot, even in tight. Hey, look, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting in the paint, and they keep scoring points.
And you know, Brian, there's not really a lot you can do as a defense when they keep getting in the paint like they have been on this run.
Here's Durr. And that time also missed a shot. Pass to Vandersloot. That one goes in for 2, making it look easy. She's now 4 for 4.
Even for a player like Quigley, who is known for her ability to score, you have someone that open, you can't miss her.
Timeout called the Liberty.
They'd seen enough scoring in the paint and wanted to send a message to their team. Lock things up inside.
Yeah, you're right, Tim. I guarantee you this talk centers around cutting down on all those points coming against them in the paint.
And maybe it's more help. It's the front of player. They've got to try something.
outside. Pass to Durr. Right side, Charles. And stolen by Lavender. Outside, Quigley. Allie Quigley is doubled. Right wing. Clock at six. Here's Vandersloot. And another basket for Chicago.
You simply cannot say enough about the quarter she's having. I mean, every one of her attempts has gone down.
Now here's Hartley. Liberty, keep it alive. Here's Nurse. Another miss, and they've really hit a rough patch. And so it's Chicago with it. 16-point lead. Dolson. And it's good for two.
I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders.
That might make the defense even worse, but that's 10 of the last 12 points they've allowed from right around the rim.
And the Liberty call time here.
Yeah, coaches, they saw their team giving up a lot of points and wanted to get a break before it got out of hand.
And that's a big part of a coach's job, making sure you keep your players in the best position possible at all times. That's a great timeout.
Nurse, she's guarded by Lavender, and that one good.
You know, she shot the ball well, but it hasn't been contagious.
Chicago in total control. Vandersloot outside. Outside, Quigley. Lavender. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot, and we'll go to the line. That one on Charles. That free throw, no good. She hits the second from the line. Now here's Hartley. Pass to Nurse. Here's Charles, guarded by Quigley. For three. Hartley's shot is off.
Yeah, and unfortunately, that's been the result for her over and over. I mean, she just cannot find the bottom of the bucket.
That one goes. Count it.
They've been the hotter team in the first half so far, guys.
Well, they've been grinding, working for those high-percentage shots, and it's been paying off for them.
And let's see if this success continues to go as we get longer into this game.
Nurse with the bucket.
A very nice rhythm to her shot. Nurse is not someone you want to start hitting threes. They can come in bunches when she gets going.
Pass to Lavender. Now Vandersloot, guarded by Charles. Here's Lavender. And so she earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact, and she'll shoot two. And this is her third and fourth free throw attempts of the game here. First one falls for her. And she makes both free throws. And the Liberty with possession here. They trail by 18. Nurse outside. And she was fouled on the way up. Two free throws for her. That one on Quigley.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Both shots good from the stripe.
Even though they're trailing, I love the job they've been doing getting to the free throw line and trying to get some easy points.
You know, they should stay aggressive, and they have been, not settling.
Now here's Lavender. 9 points in the game. The rebound by the Liberty. In transition, here come the Liberty. Here's Nurse. The basket drops, and she gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming up for her. And this is her third trip to the line tonight.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
With the prospect of making a big lead even bigger.
They should jump at this chance. Stretch that lead out as much as possible.
Inside. And the basket by Lavender.
They're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
No luck needed. It is working for sure. Five of their last six field goals, they've come from inside the paint.
Here's Zowie B. And she floats it in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
She is one of the best when it comes to making the sweet lead pass.
To the inside, Dolson. And that comes off the assist by Courtney Vandersloot.
Defensively, they've been unable to shut down the most important part of the court, Brian, the middle.
Yeah, and the point totals in the paint are tilted heavily against them now.
Now here's Nurse. She's got 16. Here's the three. Second chance shot. Zowie B gets the bucket.
He got caught standing around that time and giving up the second chance points.
They need more effort than that on the boards. That can't happen.
Absolutely.
Good.
Unselfish basketball on the interior. That's the kind of pass a coach loves to see.
From downtown, knocks down the trifecta. The clock runs out, and we're heading to halftime. It's the Sky. They lead by 12. And we'll see you right after halftime for the beginning of the third quarter.
Welcome back to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the final two quarters. Kia Nurse has been sensational.
Her decision-making, simply flawless today. Nothing but quality shots from her in the first half. She wasn't forcing anything.
Yeah, but I think here in the second half, they may want her to be a little more assertive and start taking more shots, even the tough ones.
And as we begin the second half, first half wasn't even close. And we'll see if there is a comeback on our hands or more of the same as we get the third started.
Now here's DeShields. Courtney Vandersloot for three. The rebound by Zowie B.
Just like me, 9 times out of 10, she's going to bury the three when she's left all alone like that. She's simply too quick for her defender. Left her in the rear view and knocked it down.
Stolen by Brittany Boyd. A solo fast break. And the lead is down inside single digits.
That's picture-perfect anticipation from Boyd. Didn't get too anxious and lunged at the right time.
Now here's Vandersloot. Stolen by Zowie B.
Durer with it. She's picked up by DeShields. Charles. Rebound Chicago. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead. Outside DeShields. Makes it off the glass.
A hard worker who understands the nuances of the game. DeShields loves to learn and is comfortable running the pick and roll.
Charles, no good.
Well, you love the tough D, especially inside.
And that's exactly what she gives you, Tim. Constantly making her presence felt around the rim. That's how to orchestrate for your teammate. Terrific pass.
Now here's Boyd. She's covered closely. Charles. She's guarded by Lavender. And they pick up two.
Great ball movement and ends with Charles making the extra pass. She has a great feel for the game.
Now here's Vandersloot. Boyd covering. Vandersloot outside. Down low. A nice shot by DeShields.
They're 3 of 4 to start the half.
Just under 2.5 minutes into this third quarter now. And they double up Tina Charles. Zowie B. Charles. She's guarded by Lavender. Durr. Good. And the assist goes to Brittany Boyd.
Yeah, I admire Boyd's intuition as a floor general. It's almost like she sees plays develop before the defense does.
Now here's Dolson. She's got 10. 2 points. That one goes in.
A nice start to the second half. Just one miss in their first 5 attempts.
Pass to Durr. Outside Charles. Now here's Boyd. 6 to shoot. Durr. Good work defensively by Stephanie Dolson. Fast break Chicago from deep alley Quigley. The putback, great positioning on the putback.
Yeah, she's played an important role in her offense today, and really without her, they might not have the lead right now.
Pass to Zowie B. Boyd, Vandersloot defending. Boyd can't get it to go. Left side to Shields. Shoots on the block, and it's Chicago with another.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic, and it's a big part of why they've been able to get good looks.
Absolutely. The defense unable to react quickly enough to deal with their passing. That pass allowed her to get straight to the rim in perfect stride.
Chicago with the ball. It's a 14-point game. Timeout called the Sky.
Here's Faulkner. She's got six. Pass to Endor. Five to shoot. Copper. Rebound, Tina Charles. Up top right. Here's Zowie B. Foul called that time on the way up, and that'll give her two chances at the free throw line. And this is her first free throw of the game. The first one falls. Both good at the line. Chicago with the ball. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead. Williams inside. She has six. Here's Parker. Good, and it's Gabby Williams who picks up the assist.
Bringing hustle and heart to the court, Parker has become indispensable for her team.
Outside Boyd. Ooh, no luck on that one. So Chicago will take it the other way. Pass to Copper. From downtown. Good on the three-point shot.
I mean, that shot just becomes effortless for her when the defense is so relaxed like that.
Here's Allen. Faulkner defending. Now Zowie B. She's got 15. Here's Charles. It's stolen by Parker. Outside Williams. Faulkner. Pass to Endor. Williams. Shoots the three. No luck on that one. So New York will take it the other way. Here's Boyd. Banked in off the glass.
Impressive mobility from Boyd. She can be shifty when driving to the basket.
Now here's Williams, guarded closely. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Liberty. Here's Wright. Knocks it loose. Up top, Zowie B. Pass to Allen. Lets it go from deep. Nailed from three-point land.
Defense was pretty much non-existent there. Can't leave such a good shooter open like that. Come on.
Here's Copper. Outside Williams. Just five on the clock. Chicago the rebound. She's off on that one. It's Tanisha Wright on the wing. And Vandersloot over to help. Pass to Allen. Now Wright. Here's Johannes. Back to right. Here's Copper. She has five. And so she draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. It's going to be on Amanda Zowie B.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one drops. And so she makes both from the line. And the Liberty with possession here. They trail by 14. Pass to right. Lays it up and in off the nice reverse.
There's a pattern taking shape. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Yeah, four of their last five baskets have been of exactly that variety.
Here's Copper. Back to Vandersloot. Here's Endor. Covered by Zowie B. And she drops in the layup off glass.
How great would it be to have Courtney Vandersloot as your point guard? She might be the best passer we've seen in this league.
And stolen by Courtney Vandersloot. They're running. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's an 86% accuracy mark. Pass to Zowie B. Here's Allen. Here's Johannes. And here is Zowie B. Vandersloot defending. To the middle. Clock is at three. Here's Allen. Drops in the layup for two.
Crash the boards with purpose right there. Some hard-earned second-chance points.
Vandersloot outside. The shot, no good. Amanda Zowie B with the defensive effort. Pass to Hartley. Johannes. For three. The shot misses. And Chicago will come the other way. Outside, Williams. To the paint. The fader. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Here's Johannes. And first trip to the free throw line for her in this one. The first free throw is good. The Sky making a switch here. And good on the second, so she makes both.
Some great free throw shooting so far here in the second half.
They should keep trying to initiate contact to get back to the line until they start missing from there. But as it is, they are perfect so far.
And you get the points, and you stop the clock.
That's how you do it.
Now here's Hartley. Here's Allen. Pass to Hartley. Allen. Johannes. Vandersloot defending. Here's Allen. And again, it's the Liberty missing.
A good board there, but overall, they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
And they've just got to find a way to get back into this game. That's as good a place as any.
Just increase the effort on the boards. Even double team, she had the vision to see the open player.
Now here's Hartley. D right on her. Lays it up and in despite the excellent defense.
Vandersloot outside. They get the rebound. Score that one for her eighth field goal. 8 for 11, in fact, on an accurate night.
That's the third bucket in a row from the paint. And I know nobody likes a traffic jam, but this defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Yeah, nobody likes a traffic jam. We can agree on that. They can't allow the offense to get those high-quality looks inside.
Here's Copper. She has 7. Vandersloot. Pass to Dolson. It's not going to go for her. Amanda Zawibi with the defensive effort. 3 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. To the left wing. Back to Hartley. And off target on the 15-footer. Here's Copper. A monumental buzzer beater.
A thrilling shot for one team, and boy, what a heartbreaker for the other.
And you gotta admire the ice in her veins. What a shot.
Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. Sky out in front, leading by 17. And now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
Well, this is what being on the same page looks like. Fantastic feed and a heads-up play all around.
And how could you not be a fan of a sequence like that? This is what beautiful basketball is all about.
Yeah, unselfishness, just wonderful stuff.
Welcome back. Fourth quarter of action starting up in what has been a one-side show. On offense, here the Liberty. 17-point game. Pass to Nurse. Zawibi, guarded by Dolson. Now here's Durr. Defense right on him. Count it.
She had that burst on the first step, right to the rim.
And here's Quigley. And Vandersloot gets it to go.
To score at under 6 feet, inside, against good D, you have to be tough like Courtney Vandersloot.
Pass to Durr. Charles. And here is Hartley. Back to Charles. Good, and the assist goes to Bria Hartley.
No one hard to stop inside. At 6'4", with the move she has, Charles was made to score in the paint.
Now here's Vandersloot. She's guarded by Hartley. With the shot. Vandersloot, no good.
I guess even she misses those easy opportunities once in a while.
To the right side. Pass to Durr. To the left side wing. Zawibi with it. She's picked up by DeShields. Charles with it. Over Lavender. Charles, no good.
Yeah, I mean, that's not heads-up basketball. Why try the fadeaway when no one's on you?
Chuck up 2 right there.
Becoming more of a scorer. As her career has progressed, Vandersloot has had more nights like tonight, taking over as the offensive star.
Durr, covered by DeShields. Inside, Nurse. It falls through, making her 6 for 11 in this contest.
Well, she, for one, hasn't let them down, but a few of her teammates need to pick up the pace and pick it up fast.
And Vandersloot gets it to go.
You know, she's pretty comfortable inside. Vandersloot has practiced scoring near the rim so much, and she's as good as any point guard in the league at scoring inside.
Nurse outside. Zawibi, good on the shot.
She is setting this place on fire. Her shooting has been off the charts.
Now here's Vandersloot. She's tightly guarded. Beyond the arc. That doesn't go either for Courtney Vandersloot. Hartley outside. Sinks the triple.
She might not have the long-range ability of some other players in this league, but she'll knock down open ones like that.
Quigley with it, and Nurse picks her up defensively. Up top, Vandersloot. Shoots over Hartley. And misses it off the right side of the rim. To the paint. Up and in on the layup.
She's pouring it on in the second half. Really a much better showing than she had before the break.
Time called here. The Sky decide to talk it over.
Yeah, I think the coach is trying to take the wind out of their sails here. They're on the wrong end of a run and need to sort things out offensively and defensively.
Yeah, things were starting to spiral out of control on them a little bit, and a timeout was a no-brainer there. Yeah,
exactly, Brian.
Pass to Vandersloot. Now here's Quigley. To the wing on the left. Zawi B on the double team. Six on the shot clock. Here's Quigley. And that one goes in as she's fouled. It'll be 3 points if she can convert the free throw.
Well, few players understand the value of a good role player more than Allie Quigley. She's a two-time sixth woman of the year, and really, she's as unselfish as they come.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
And the free throw, no good. And when you look at Quigley's standout traits, I'm a fan of her preparation.
Absolutely, Blake. She's ready to go whenever the team needs her. Quigley knows exactly what to expect of her, doesn't try to do too much. Unstoppable offense for both teams. I love the pace of this game.
Yeah, the pace is only picking up the deeper we get into this game. This has absolutely been a fun one to watch.
It's good.
And she's having a quarter, converting at a high percentage.
Here's Boyd. Pass to Durr. Zawi B. To the middle. Puts it up from 15. Here's Charles. Chicago with the rebound. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead. To the inside. The putback. It's good on the putback.
Demands so much attention from the opposition. DeShields' game is years ahead of her young WNBA peers.
Pass to Nurse. Out to the left wing. That shot off the mark. Some solid defense from Jontel Lavender. Courtney Vandersloot for three. Rebound, Tina Charles. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, it's been a long time without a bucket. Focus.
The shot's good.
Well, look, one of the reasons they're trailing is because we haven't seen enough of that. She has to become a bigger part of her offense.
Outside to Shields. Let's loose for three. No good there. So New York will take it the other way. Nurse outside. Pass to Charles. Boyd guarded by Quigley. Outside Boyd. Down low. Zowie B gets the bucket.
Well, she's been the key to their offense. She's been their offense with the way she shot the ball.
Yeah, her percentage today has been through the roof. She is definitely not the one who's put them in this hole.
DeShields with it. She's picked up by Durr. Outside Quigley. Andersloot outside. Good work defensively by Brittany Boyd. Durr, left side Charles. Shoots over Quigley. Again, the Liberty, good for two.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it did not work. Not if it results in that shot.
Pass to Vandersloot. Lavender, guarded by Charles. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession.
That pass had a little bit too much heat on it for her to make a clean steal.
Yeah, that was going to be a tough catch for either of them. I mean, these are basketball players, not wide receivers.
Outside to Shields. Five to shoot. Pass to Lavender. It's good. The assist that time from Diamond to Shields.
They've been able to depend on her offense all game, guys. She's just not wasting any chances, any shots she's had.
And if they want to make things even easier on themselves here late in the ball game, I got an idea. Just keep getting her the basketball. What a feel-good story, right? I mean, she has been much more effective in the second half than she was in the first.
Pass to Dolson. Back to Vandersloot. A beautiful reverse layup.
Well, they can't ask much more of her than what she's done this quarter.
Boyd with it. To the middle. Durr. Free throw is good. She's perfect from the line this time. Chicago in the lead. Pass to Lavender. Quigley with it. Guarded by Charles. Here's DeShields. Shot clock at six. They double-team Diamond DeShields. Vandersloot with it. Shoots over Boyd. Some solid defense from Brittany Boyd. Now here's Durr. Guarded by Quigley. Up top, Boyd. Nurse outside. Good for basket number seven tonight on a not-so-unlucky 13 shots.
The shots finally dropping for them in bunches, and the complexion of this game has changed.
That was the only thing that could have brought them back in this game. Everything had to start falling. Boy, have they gotten hot.
On the wing, Diamond to Shields. Back to Lavender. Wide open. The rebound by Charles. New York trailing here. And even three-on-three break. Pass to Zowie B. Durr. Back to Zowie B. Boyd. Vandersloot defending. To the inside. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
Big time from Charles. Remember, she's a national champ, gold medalist. She loves these moments. She's been in these moments.
Now here's Vandersloot. Boyd covering. Second shot opportunity. So she gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. Two shots next.
Shooting two.
That free throw missing. She's good on the second. And so it's New York with it. Trailing by five. To the paint. Here's Charles. Charles controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
There aren't many better in league history on the O board. Charles is tenacious on the glass and getting the hoop.
Outside to Shields. Inside, Dolson. It's good. The assist that time from Diamond to Shields.
Clutch by Dolson. She's been in every big game from college to overseas of the WNBA. Dolson with no fear of the big moment.
Here's Charles. And plenty of contact on the shot, so the two free throws coming up. And that's going to be a foul on Chicago. Gets the first, and that shrinks the margin to just four. And that one goes in, two from the line that time.
A lot of players say they want to be in those situations, but she truly does. What a clutch performer.
Now here's the Shields. Not a lot of room. They double-team Diamond to Shields. Dolson, shot's good.
A myriad of moves and ways to score inside. Dolson is excellent close to the basket.
Now here's Boyd. Vandersloot defending. Down low. A nice shot by Charles.
That's why you look for Charles. She's played in so many big games. The big moment, it does not affect her at all.
Vandersloot outside. Outside Quigley. Clock at six. Pass to Dolson. Vandersloot, Boyd covering. The three. And that's good. Courtney Vandersloot for three.
Monster bucket from Vandersloot. She just oozes confidence late in games. Wants the ball, wants the shot.
Timeout called the Liberty. Man, what do you guys think?
Quick bucket then foul. It's really the only option they have at this point.
And the important thing, Tim, is who they foul. They don't want to send an ace to the line if they can avoid it.
Exactly, Brian. Find the worst free throw shooter immediately.
And now the presentation of our Jordan player of the game, Courtney Vandersloot.
On the attack all game, she's been merciless, imposing her will early, often setting the tone, and then she's kept her foot on the gas pedal.
Now here's Hartley. Pass to Charles. Back to Hartley. There's the double team with DeShields. The shot by Nurse, no good. And Tina Charles is going to pick up the foul. And so she's picked up her final foul, and she will sit the rest of this one out. Get a comfy seat. That's it. And she commits the intentional foul.
Shooting two.
So the first one drops, and that makes it a 7-point lead. So she goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's an 8-point ball game, and the Liberty call time here. And what's your take, guys?
I applaud them for trying until the very end, but this one's in the bag.
Absolutely. The only thing this timeout's going to do is draw out the misery a little bit longer.
And we've got dinner plans tonight.
Here's Johannes. Tries a three off the inbound. Rebounded by Parker. Here's Jackson. So it's Chicago picking up the win. This was a very strong showing for them. Not necessarily a runaway win, but one they'll feel very good about.
Well, guys, anytime you can go on the road and win in the fashion they did, you should feel good about it. A really outstanding team effort.
That'll do it for our broadcast, everyone.